The data on the screen shows information about the employees in the company. Attributes like employee number, team, gender, job satisfaction, and age are shown. This is the network data of the influence between the employees from before. One row shows the link between two employees. This type of data is called an edge list. Next, this is the network data of the communication between employees. A data type that is structured with rows and columns is called a matrix. There is a number at the intersection of the rows and columns that shows the link between two people. Now I will import the Excel data from before into NetMiner. Select File and choose the fitting data type. I've now brought some basic information about the employees. Now I will bring the network data of the influence between employees. If there are multiple sheets in Excel, you can select the sheets you need. Again, select the fitting data type and import the data. I've now imported additional information about the imported employees from earlier. Also, the edge list data is automatically changed and saved as the matrix data type. Lastly, I will bring the network data of the communication between employees. I will select the data type as matrix and import the network. I will import the Excel file into NetMiner. Now I will calculate the basic attributes of the two networks. I am going to calculate things like number of links, density, average degree, mean distance, and clustering coefficient. You can also compare the different network properties from the community. This time, I will check which central person is connected with the most people. I have measured the centrality of the employees. If we sort the employees in the order of highest centrality, we can find the major groups. Now we will check the groups that are stuck together. We can find a total of 7 cohesion groups in the influence network. In NetMiner, we can add the analysis results as a part of the dataset. I will add the cohesion group analysis result as community. I will also add the centrality analysis result as centrality. The additional analysis results are now added as employee attributes. Now I will visualize the imported data. I'm going to create a network map using the data extracted from the cohesion analysis results from before. A map is created from the cohesion analysis results. Now I will add the centrality analysis results and which department the employees are in. I will change the size of the dot by centrality and change the color for different departments. You can also change the label of the dots as names instead of employee numbers. The query function extracts part of data through conditional expressions. I will now be extracting the data of only the male employees. Select an attribute that will act as a standard for extracting the data. Enter a value to complete the conditional expression. As you can see, the data of only the male employees have been extracted. The program NetMiner also provides a script function for more automatic and expansive use. A Python-based script engine is included. And so, if you're used to using Python, you can easily use the script function to control the program. The script that I am using is a code to visualize both of the networks I've imported earlier. If you have a script written out, you can visualize multiple networks at the click of a button. You can automatically create two network maps without even having to open and run it through the menu. Now I will use the script function to run a complicated analysis with just one click. You can save previously written scripts as a plugin and add it like a menu. This script automatically shows the results of the ANOVA, crosstabs, and correlation analysis using the network analysis results and the attributes of the employees. You can now complete a process that would have required numerous clicks in one simple click. Like this, you can see the many analysis results in a single report. I've imported the Excel file to NetMiner.